That's all I ever done, mess with wood. Started out with pulpwood, then went sawtimber. Then quit and start back with firewood, got old. And damn, that's hell in it.
This back hand's old. Yeah. Most all this old hand's old. It's mixed oak and maple and all kind of wood. Gum, all different kinds.
My daddy run a sawmill, and I could start working with him with damn wood when I was in school. Get out of school, we worked with wood, and I just kept at it. Got me old pulpwood truck when I quit school and started hauling pulpwood. And kept growing, kept getting bigger and bigger. Now I'm getting smaller, I'm going back to 75.
Well, me and my father went in business in 1977 together, but I've been doing it ever since I was 16 years old. Well, it's changed a lot over the years. When we first started out, we cut 5-foot pulpwood, and we had to load it with our hands. And over the years, they built stuff to do all the work with you. Now, besides having machines, you have to cut down with chainsaws, you got machines to cut all the trees, and got machines to delim them. Cut them out, really. Got a machine that cuts the logs and everything. Really, the hands in the woods, they ain't got to do that much. It made a big change over the years. Granddaddy was, that's all they done ever since they was farmers, and they would cut pulpwood. He ran a sawmill, had his own sawmill, sawed lumber. But I think, as far as I know, he sawed the lumber to build about all his son, daughter's houses. I think he sawed all that. And I know whenever I grew up and got the Hepperman sawmill, we saw lumber for lots of people to build houses. But back then it didn't have to be inspected and graded and everything. But now all that's got to be graded and inspected, and you can't just take it off a sawmill and go do it no more. It's got to come out of a mill that's got to have a stamp on it. If it's not stamped, you cannot use it to build a house, even though it's number one lumber. It sits back behind his old store building now. It used to sit right where our wood shed is at. Where we sell firewood from. It used to sit right there when I was a kid growing up. Shovel lots of sawdust and all that. I enjoyed it. When I first started out helping my granddaddy, I made 25 cents. Work all afternoon, paid 25 cents. He'd buy you a Pepsi Cola and give you a pack of crackers. Back then, Pepsi Cola cost 10 cents, a pack of crackers cost a nickel. Oh, as the years went on, I got to working in what they call the bullpen, where you carry the slabs of lumber out, and I started making $2 an hour. I thought I was in the big money then. I was a little teenager, and I thought I was getting rich. My grandpa used to tell me, the top man back whenever he came up, top man didn't make over 50 cents a day, all day long. Average man made 35 cents. But his best employee he had made 50 cents a day. Well, Daddy kind of runs the firewood business, and I kind of run a logging crew for a company out of Newberry. I hope my sons take over my firewood business, but all of them got good jobs, so I know they ain't going to be out here doing no logging. I'm planning on continuing that firewood business that I can't do it no longer. This is the old sawmill. Used to be a diesel engine that sat right over here to pull the mill. That pulled the mill sat right over there, belonging to my daddy and my uncle. The sawdust pile was out that way.